Do you know that even Jesus had an addiction as well? And I know that that comes as a surprise to you. Jesus said in Luke 22 verse 42, Father, please take this cup of suffering away from me. Yet not my will be done, but your will be done. In other scriptures he said, I don't say anything unless I hear my Father tells me to say it. I don't do anything unless I hear my Father tells me to do it. Jesus said, I am in the Father and he is in me. So Jesus' addiction was this. Jesus was addicted to doing the will of the Father. And to take it further, God was addictive and still addicted today. And you know what God's addiction is? God is addicted to loving you, and God is addicted to loving me as well. And as I said in other videos as well, 1 John 4 verse 8 and 1 John 4 verse 16 says that God is love. So even God has an addiction, my friend. And the big question is, who do you blame for your addictions and everything else that you went through in life? Stay tuned as I share with you in this video and answer that question for you right at the end of this video. If this is your first time on my channel and this channel appeals to you and you love the content that I'm sharing, then please do this quickly. Okay, if you want engagement on my channel, you have to be signed in on YouTube. Right here in the middle, there's a thumbs up. That is to show that you like my video. Thumbs down to show that you don't like my video. That arrow, share. You can share there with friends or family as well. And then the main thing as well, subscribe is written in red. You can click on there, a clock will, so you can click on the clock. And then the word all will be available. You can click on all as well. Now, right on here, there's no button for comments. And this is how you comment. You go right to the bottom. And right to the bottom, there will be something that says add a comment. It's not here right now. But then you can just add a comment right at the bottom of the video. So now that you have it, now we can continue. Okay, firstly, I want to make a simple illustration with you. And I promise you that even my 5-year-old daughter will understand what I'm about to share with you. It's a very simple, straightforward, great oral illustration that I'm about to share with you. I have a glass in my hand, you know, and this glass has nothing in it. It simply has nothing in it. So this glass has nothing that it can offer me. Now I have a sweet here in my hand. And if I put the sweet here in the cup, you can see here, there's only one sweet in this glass, and what this glass has to offer me is only one sweet. This glass can't offer me two sweets or three sweets. It can only offer me one sweet. Why? Because its greatest potential is to offer me one sweet. That is glass number one. And here is glass number two. I'm gonna put in 10 sweets right now. So now glass number two has 10 sweets in it, which means that the capacity of this glass number two is to be able to give me 10 sweets. This glass can't give me 12 sweets or 13 sweets. It can only give me 10 sweets. Now, if glass one, who only had one sweet in it, if glass one only give me that one sweet, then it means that it gave me 100% of what it could give me. And glass number two can only give me 80%. If it gave me 8 sweets, then it only gave me 80% of what it had. Now, glass one with the one sweet in it represents our parents and everyone else that we blame for our addictions and everything else that we went through in life. Now I can say to you right now that our parents gave us 100%. They gave us everything that they could. And I know that a lot of people blame their parents for their addictions and everything else that they went through in life. I used to do that with my mom as well. I used to blame my mom for every mistake that I made, for every failure that I experienced, for everything else. I used to blame my mom the fact that I could not play professional soccer today as well. The very first thing that people used to ask me when I just entered the building at treatment centers, why did you do the things that you did and who do you blame? And I responded like an automated email machine. You know, when you apply to companies with your email, they respond. There's an automated email machine. And I replied like that. I immediately said, my mom or my family. And how many of you out there blame your parents for everything that you went through? And here's the truth. I can't blame my parents or anyone else for my addictions and pain. You know why? Because they can blame their parents and their parents can blame their parents. And we can go all the way back to Adam and Steve. I mean, sorry, Eve. That was supposed to be a joke. You know, and then Adam can blame Eve. And Eve can say, no, but it's the snake. And the snake can say, no, but it's the devil. And the devil can just say, ach no, I don't know what you guys are talking about. Can you see what happens when you do the blame game? One blames the other blames another, and it goes on and on and on like that. For instance, if my mom was an angry person and very strict with me as well, and I judge my mom for doing that, then you guess what? Then that judgment that I put upon my mom, that judgment will come upon me, and I will become an exact representation of my mom. I will become a duplicate of my mom, and my children will experience me being angry and me being strict with them as well. So therefore, it's important that we don't judge our family and judge other people less. That will come and fall upon your life as well. On the other hand, to the parents, you don't have to feel condemned for the way you raised your children, because you gave your children everything you knew and everything you owned. And I am not the sharpest knife in the drawer, but I've learned this one principle, that I don't have to continue with this blame game. I can stop the blame game and take responsibility for my actions. Are you one of those that says, I smoke because my parents smoke? Are you one of those that says, I drink because my parents drink? Are you one of those that says, I gamble because my parents gamble? Are you one of those that says, I do this and that because my parents and other people do this and that? Here's the truth, my friend. I'm going to answer the question that I posed right in the beginning for you right now. And I asked this question: who is responsible for your addictions and everything else that you went through in life, in terms of your pain and rejection and your misery and humiliation and all of that? Who is responsible for that? And here's the answer: you are responsible, my friend. You are to blame. I am to blame for my addictions, and I am to blame for my own pain as well. And when I realized that, change started to happen. You see, in life, we always have a choice, whether you know it or not. So it doesn't matter where you come from, it doesn't matter your circumstances or your situation. And I know you can easily say, oh, but my circumstance chose for me or choose for me. But I want to correct you by saying that no, you choose. You always have a choice. No one can choke you to choose what to do, whatever. You have a choice. And let me tell you this, whether you choose to do good or bad, there's consequences to both your decisions and choices. You see, I can't even blame the devil. You know why? Because the Bible says that the devil is like a roaring lion. That's all that he can do. He can just roar like a lion. But the truth is, he can make noise in my head as well. But at the end of the day, I am still the one that makes the choice. It's the same like I can't stop a bird from pooing on my head, but I can stop it from building a nest on my head. And that is how it is with thoughts as well. If the devil put thoughts in your head, you can either choose to entertain it, or you can choose to not act out on it. But the choice is always yours. I hope that I've answered some of your questions in this video clip. And I also hope that you've enjoyed this video today. If you have any questions, or if there's anything happening in your heart right now, then please share with me by commenting in this video below. And if there's anything or any advice that you would like to give me in terms of anything or everything, then please do so by commenting below. Thank you. In ending, thank you very much for sacrificing your valuable time listening to this video clip. Don't forget to subscribe and to share this video with friends and family. See you next week, Monday, 6 p.m. Same time, different place, same voice, same face.